Let us see another example, students. Under the same type, the question says, solve d square y by dx square plus 3dy by dx plus 2y is equal to 4 cos square x. Okay. First, we have to put it in the operator form. Okay? So, putting it in the operator form, we get d square plus 3d plus 2 into y is equal to 4 cos square 2x. But 4 cos square x, but instead of cos square x, I will not keep it as it is. Instead of cos square x, I am going to, because we cannot substitute under, even though it is, this comes under type 2, this is not cos 2x. Cos 2x is in the form of cos ax, we can do it directly. But it is cos square x. We cannot substitute anything here. For square, it doesn't come under type 2. You got to reduce it to this type 2. How do we do that? For that, we make use of our basic trigono skills. What does this say? See, we know that from one of the basic trigonometric formulae. So, we know that cos 2x is equal to 2 cos square x minus 1. Okay? So, rearrange this formula and find what is cos square x. So, we get cos 2x plus 1, the whole divided by 2 is cos square x. So, I am going to replace cos square x by this here. So, what do I get? Cos 2x plus 1 the whole divided by. Okay. So, this is how I get it. Right. Now, let us simplify further. Here 2 and 4 get cut. So, this is what will be our phi of x. Now, writing the auxiliary equation to get the first part of the solution. We have f of m equal to 0 given by m square plus 3m plus 2 is equals to 0. Okay. So, find the factors of this. So, what are the factors for 2? We can take plus 1 and plus 2. So, m square splitting the middle term plus 1m plus 2m plus 2 is equal to 0. Take the common. So, m into m plus 1 plus 2 into m plus 1 is equals to 0. So, this gives us m plus 1 into m plus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, we have m is minus 1 and minus 2. These are the two roots of the given auxiliary equation. So, what we will do now? We will consider the first part of the solution given by yc. Okay, what is yc? I forgot to write what is d here. You guys got to remember this. D is always t by dx. Anyways, yc. Yc is equal to, these two are unique roots. So, distant roots or unique roots, whatever you can call it. So, c1 e to the power, this value is the coefficient of x. So, minus 1x is minus x plus c2 e to the power minus 2x. This is our complementary function. That is the first part of the solution. Next we have particular integral is given by y phi of x divided by f of d. What is phi of x, guys? Phi of x, we just got it simplified here. 2 cos 2x plus 2 1 is 2. The whole divided by nothing. There is f of d. What is f of d here? D square plus 3d plus 2. Okay, so that is your f of d. Next we have this comes under, we can split it into two parts. 2 cos 2x divided by d square plus 3d plus 2 plus 2 divided by d square plus 3d plus 2 can be considered as p1 and p2. So, solving them separately, we have P1 is equal to 2 cos 2x divided by d square plus 3d plus 2. This is again under type 2. This is type 2, remember. And this is a combination of two types. This comes under type 2 and this can be considered under type 1. I'll show you how. Anyways, as it is type 2, we need to replace d square by minus a square, and a in this case is minus 2. So, we will be replacing it here. We get 2 cos 2x as it is divided by minus 4 plus 3d plus 2. This gets simplified further. Cos 2x divided by minus 4 plus 2 is minus 2. 3d is as it is. As in the previous case, you got to multiply and divide it by its conjugate. And the conjugate in this case, because there is a negative sign, you got to take a positive sign here. Okay, so doing that, we get 2 cos 2x into 3d. So I'll just multiply and write it directly. So 3d into 2 cos 2x plus 2 into 2 cos 2x, the whole divided by, again it is in the form of a minus b into a plus b, which can be written as a square minus b square. Now I told you what is d. D here is our d by dx. So applying d by dx here, 3 2's is 6, and derivative of cos 2x is minus 2 sin 2x plus 4 cos 2x, the whole divided by, this is going to be 9 d square minus 4. Once again, this is again under type 2. So replacing d square by minus a square, where a is 2 in both the terms. So you can merge and then take it without separating. This is going to be 6 2's is 18 sin 2x plus 4 cos 2x, whole divided by, substituting d square is minus 4. So you are going to get, so minus 4 is common down. So 9 plus 1, 10. 10 into minus 4, minus 40. So you get a minus 18 cos 2x. I can take out a 2 common in both the terms in the numerator. So you can take out 2 common, minus sin 2x plus 2 cos 2x, the whole divided by, this is minus 4 into 10. So we get minus 1, 20 in the denominator. So you get 9 by 20 sin 2x plus 1 by 10, sorry, minus 1 by 10 cos 2x. This is our P1. Now let us go ahead and find what is our P2. Okay, so to find P2, P2 is this one, 2 divided by d square plus 3d plus 2. So 2 divided by d square plus 3d plus 2. But this can be considered as type 1 by introducing e power 0x, where d can be replaced by coefficient of x in the exponential form, that is 0. D is supposed to be replaced by 0 in the denominator. So you get 2 into 1 divided by, this is replacing by 0 we get. So 2 and 2 gets cut. 1 is the P2 answer. Got it, guys? So now final solution is given by y is equal to yc plus yp. This implies y is equal to, what is our yc? These two terms you got to write. C1 e power minus x plus C2 e power minus 2x plus yp. Yp has two terms, guys. P1 and P2. Both the terms has to be taken. Okay. So P1 solution is 9 by 20 sin 2x minus 1 by 10 cos 2x. Okay. So that is our P1 solution. Now adding up the P2 solution, which is going to be equal to 1 in this case. So adding up that part, we get this much as our final solution. Nothing can be simplified further. So you got to leave it as it is. Got it?